Are you bored with slurping chicken broth and sick of vegetable stew? Then I'll give you a simple recipe for a tasty treat that's new. Now before we get this started, I really must confess that to make a successful monster stew, you must make a great big mess. Slip-slop, gobbly-gloop, it's enough to feed a great big group. The werewolves bark and the banshees whoop when they catch a whiff of monster soup. So to keep your mom from screaming and your little sis from snitchin', make sure your family's on vacation or at least out of the kitchen. Now we can start without delay this delicious monster feast that's guaranteed to fill you up and burp like a bander beast. Slip-slop, gobbly-gloop, it's enough to feed a great big group. The werewolves bark and the banshees whoop when they catch a whiff of monster soup. Most of the soup's ingredients can be found underneath your bed, nightmares in your head. Now get a pot that stinks as bad as the toenails of a troll and fill it up with dirty water from a stagnant sewer hole. Pluck 2 dozen moldy teeth from your favorite monster's jaws and scrape some mold from a bugaboo's ear with sharp sea serpent claws. Slip slop, gobbly gloop, stir it round in a loop de loop. Then call up all your friends to come and help you slurp down your monster soup. It's good for your monster soup.